Once again, we hope that interrupting the Antiques Roadshow to bring you the momentous events in South Africa didn't spoil your enjoyment too much. And there'll be another chance to see the programme when it's repeated on BBC Two Wales on Thursday afternoon at 2:15. Well, because of our coverage of South Africa, today's episode of It Doesn't Have to Hurt has been postponed to a later date. On BBC Two Wales in 10 minutes, the Money programme reports on the increased access that is now available into the Japanese financial market and the country's industrial response. Here in Quarter of an Hour, we've a special Songs of Praise from Johannesburg. You're watching BBC One Wales, where now Moira Stuart has the news at 6:25 on Sunday, the 11th of February.
After 27 years in South African jails, Nelson Mandela is a free man. At 2:15 today, our time, he walked from the gates of Victor Verster prison, hand in hand with his wife, Winnie. Some 500,000 people waited in Cape Town for hours to hear their leader address them for the first time in more than a quarter of a century.
I greet you all in the name of peace, democracy and freedom for all.
Good evening. Nelson Mandela is free. He walked out of Victor Verster prison this afternoon, hand in hand with his wife, Winnie, after 27 years in South African jails. They waved to cheering crowds, then their convoy of cars set out on the 40-mile drive to Cape Town. Up to 500,000 of his supporters waited for hours to welcome him outside the city hall. But there was trouble in nearby streets. Looters smashed shop windows and police opened fire with birdshot and tear gas. When the black nationalist leader finally arrived, he told the crowd there was no alternative to continuing the armed struggle. And he said sanctions must go on to isolate the apartheid regime.
Nelson Mandela's first steps back to freedom. After more than a third of his life behind bars, his wife Winnie at his side, the world's first sight of a man considered so dangerous by South Africa's previous white rulers, he was kept hidden, unphotographed, for over 25 years. Today, at the age of 71, Mr. Mandela lives up to all the descriptions of a fit, disciplined man. Now considered so vital to South Africa's future, President de Klerk took the step shirked by his predecessors and freed Mr. Mandela to the world. At the prison to greet him, thousands of South Africans, black and white, pinning their hopes on a hero until today, a revered symbol of the fight against apartheid. From today, the political leader they believe commands enough respect with black majority and white minority to negotiate an end to white rule. As Mr. Mandela was driven through an excited, disciplined crowd, all looked set for a triumphant return to a changing South Africa. But the nationalist leader was 75 minutes later than expected leaving prison. And in Cape Town, huge crowds waiting in the exhausting summer sun all day for Mr. Mandela's first words to the world at a rally were growing restless. Most stayed calm and quiet, but at the edges of the crowd, clashes were developing with riot police. We saw groups of youth looting shops. Police firing shotguns, marshals from the Mandela Release Committee trying to intervene. With the rally degenerating into chaos and violence at the fringes of the crowd, this is hardly the atmosphere of calm and dignity which both Nelson Mandela and President de Klerk want to herald the new South Africa. Making vain efforts to control the vast crowd, the Reverend Alan Busack appealed for an end to stone throwing, for order so that Nelson Mandela could safely appear. But his appeals were failing. With open conflict where it was hoped Nelson Mandela would bring peace, ANC marshals couldn't keep the two sides apart. The injured are being ferried to makeshift first aid points. The rally organisers are bewildered, not knowing how to respond. James Robbins, BBC News, Cape Town.
Nelson Mandela has just finished his historic speech to a vast and excited crowd from a balcony in Cape Town City Hall. He told them the armed struggle must go on and sanctions must be continued so as to isolate the apartheid regime.
Today, the majority of South Africans, black and white, recognize that apartheid has no future. It has to be ended by our own decisive mass action in order to build peace and security. The mass campaigns of defiance and other actions of our organizations and people can only culminate in the establishment of democracy. The factors which necessitated the armed struggle still exist today. We have no option but to continue. We express the hope that a climate conducive to a negotiated settlement would be created soon so that there may no longer be the need for the armed struggle. I am a loyal and disciplined member of the African National Congress. In conclusion, I wish to quote my own words during my trial in 1964. They are as true today as they were then. I quote, I have fought against white domination.